home of Star Family, Dorian Fraser, human activator. I'm just kind of here to share a little story with you guys today in regards to what a patient relayed to me the other day. And I just found the remark that they made was very interesting and kind of something that's pretty valid and relevant in regards to what's being perpetuated within the spiritual community. And, you know, this individual was doing a lot of self-work and also receiving a lot of work from other practitioners. You know, this individual was authentically trying to address their trauma and heal their wounds. And this was met by most practitioners with, well, you just need to love it. You need to love yourself. You just need to give it love. Now, his response to me in regards to loving his problems away was that, well, how could I love something that I've never seen before? I thought that was a very relevant perspective and point, especially in this field. Perhaps this is due to, because until you identify something, you can't do anything about it, which is why clearly one of the most important steps to obtaining emotional intelligence is being able to identify the origin of your own trauma, of your own inner turmoil and conflict. When we internalize our emotions too much, this ends up manifesting as forms of self-harm. When we externalize our emotions too much, this tends to manifest as harm to others. The path to enlightenment and achieving higher levels of consciousness or awareness, it's never butterflies and rainbows. In fact, oftentimes more than not, it's extremely painful. And the suffering, or the illusion of it anyway, is a necessary proponent in the alchemical equation of achieving higher states of being and developing character and good traits, believe it or not, because when you can put yourself in someone else's shoes, you can actually feel what they're feeling because you've been there. So you can actually have empathy for these individuals and offer help from your own perspective, from your own experience, more importantly. A lot of times, we can't just love our problems away. We have to actually address them. You know, the emotions that we repress and suppress, we have to sit with them, and we have to experience them, and we have to feel into them in their entirety to actually release them. You don't get to just focus on love and light and it's just magically fixes everything. You have to get down on your hands and knees and, you know, wax on, wax off, deal with the nitty gritty, and ultimately be rewarded. So I just thought I'd share that little story with you guys. Once again, I thought it was extremely relative to kind of some of the ideologies that are being perpetuated through the spiritual community currently. As always, it's been a pleasure to be heard, to speak, to connect. If this resonates with you, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and we look forward to connecting in the future. Be sure to check out our website as well, www.microgridactivation.com. Wholeness.